And with me for reaction now is the head of the Australian Medical Association, Dr Steve Hambleton. Thank you so much for your time. What is your reaction to the Commission of Audit and its suggestions?
Well, it's a major attempt to shift costs onto patients at every income level. And our great concern is that you can't treat health like a commodity. You can't say if we increase the prices, people will suddenly be healthier. We've certainly got to look at structural change in our health system and get people to be healthier for longer. But shifting costs onto individuals is really not the solution. And preventing people getting to the doctor, it may well lead to them delaying healthcare, actually coming into the system later, sicker, and costing more. So this could be a net cost, not a net saving. We're very concerned about it.
Dr. Hambleton, do you think the government will adopt some of the more controversial recommendations here, or what's your sense?
Look, I think the major concern we have is there were no medical people on that commission. They really didn't understand the health system. They've been actually suggesting that we go to the doctor 15 times a year. Well, that's 15 services per person per year. We actually go to the doctor about 6.5 times a year, which is about the same as the OECD average. It hasn't really recognised the fact that we've got a very good health system. And the primary healthcare part of the system, the GP, is the efficient and the inexpensive part of the system. We're not spending more than the OECD average. We're actually staying below 9% of GDP. So that's the inexpensive end. We have to look at drivers of healthcare costs if we're going to get real significant change in the system. And that's why we were very pleased the government's released this Commission of Audit so we can put some input into it. These suggestions are not going to structurally change the health of Australians. We didn't see e-health in there. We didn't see anything. We actually are very concerned that some of these organisations that can provide some audit and feedback to doctors may have been amalgamated or disappeared. So those are the sort of things that we need to work with government to deliver to make sure people who are on low income levels can afford to get primary care, can afford to get health prevention, can afford to get those chronic diseases managed in a better way to keep them out of hospital, because that's where the expense is.
Well, you're obviously not pleased with the input with the Commission of Audit, as you say, no one with medical experience on it in your view, but are you confident the government is listening to the medical profession and your concerns with the recommendations included in this report?
Well, we got the Health and Hospital Reform Commission report, which was full of doctors and full of advice from medical people, and some of those things have been suggested again. Look, the private health insurance changes, splitting up Medicare, dividing it between the rich and the poor, that's not something I think that can happen in this budget. The Minister's almost ruled that out. We're happy to see private health insurance getting more involved in general practice. We're happy to see hospitals taking a continuous view of those patients who cost the system so that they work with GPs to keep people out of hospital. So it's a whole of system reform we need. We need to work with government to deliver that. We're pretty sure that most of these things won't be delivered, and we have to make sure that people who are on low incomes, who have high needs, get access to proper health care.
One of the things inherent in the recommendations is a belief or an assumption that a lot of Australians are going to the doctor when they don't need to. Is that your understanding? Does that happen?
Well, certainly not my understanding. As I say, our OECD average visits to doctors are about the same as the rest of the world. We are talking about the low cost end of the system. And that is actually means that we do get access to people for preventive health care, for health care maintenance. Look, there are costs when you go to the doctor. It's not zero cost, as the commissioners have said. There are payments for pharmaceuticals. There's opportunity cost to actually attend the doctor's surgery. Band-aiding the system by saying emergency departments can actually charge a fee as well really is going to be a very dangerous thing. Category 4 and 5 patients in emergencies are not GP patients. They're patients who can safely wait, and many of those patients actually get admitted to hospital. The fact is the Commissioner has really misinterpreted the figures, and they needed medical guidance, and that's what we're trying to put in now so that the government understands that there may be negative impacts. You can't run hospitals like you run Coles. It just doesn't work.
Now, the Commission obviously, through its recommendations, would see the end of universal healthcare as we know. What do you think we should see from the government in response here? Obviously, you'd concede that on the current trajectory, things are unsustainable, aren't they?
Well, I think that's right. I think this probably that's the one message that comes out of this. If we project our rising costs going forward, we are getting into a situation that's very difficult to afford. Now, Australia's still pretty good than the OECD average, but it's certainly rising. We know that our state governments were very concerned about the cost of their hospital systems because that's where the expense is. And very quickly they started to agree to more federal funding. We need to make sure we fund appropriately but structurally decrease the number of people going into hospital. And that's all about tobacco, it's all about alcohol misuse, it's all about obesity in our community, 60%. A lot of that stuff is outside of the health system. We need to make it easier to walk the kids to school, we need to make it easier to choose healthy foods, we need to make it easier to do all those things that'll lead to improved outcomes within the health system. It's a package, and you've got to look everywhere to actually fix it, but you can't just superficially look at it, and certainly the GP end of the system, the primary care end of the system, is not the place to put barriers in front of people.
Dr. Steve Hambleton, President of the Australian Medical Association, thank you for your time. Appreciate